I think this is a unique time in American history.
Laying more blueprints for the return of humans to the moon. Tuesday, NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine, along with General Jay Raymond, the Chief of Space Operations for the U.S. Space Force, announced a new agreement.
Air Force Space Command, which NASA has had, you know, a memorandum of understanding with now for years. And what we do today, we're updating that memorandum of understanding so that it is now with the U.S. Space Force.
It replaces another agreement signed 14 years ago.
I will tell you that given the challenges that exist in space, it is necessary to have security. And that's why it is so important for NASA to work side by side with the Space Force.
The two groups will focus on the next big step, getting back here and allowing other countries to, keyword, peacefully join the journey.
We're putting together a coalition of nations that are going to go sustainably to the moon.
Beginning with the Artemis program, 2024 is the year to send the next man and the first woman to the moon.
This time when we go to the moon, it's not just a technology demonstration.
The hope, leaving a continued and conflict-free presence on our neighbor in the sky.
So look, if you want to be with us when we go to the moon, if you want to be with us on the Artemis program, we want you with us. But we also need you to agree to basic norms of behavior. And those basic norms of behavior are ultimately what will preserve space for humanity.
Reporting on the Space Coast, Paul Rivera, West 2 News.